Águila del sol, rescata a tus hijos.
Eagle of the sun,
Águila del sol,
your children.
Rescata a tus hijos. Águila del sol, rescata a tus hijos.
Give us your love, Mother. Your mercy, Mother. Give us your love, Divine Mother. Your mercy, Divine Mother. Take us to the sun,
en tu corazón, en tu
in your heart,
corazón,
Divine Mother.
Divina, llévanos al sol, llévanos al sol, en tu corazón, Madre Divina. misericordia, Madre, danos tu amor, Madre divina, tu misericordia, Madre divina, llévanos al sol.
Águila del sol, rescata a tus hijos. Águila del sol, rescata a tus hijos.
Llévanos al sol en tu corazón, Madre del sol.
Mother of the sun, descend to the earth the light from the immaterial source. And elevate your children towards the sun. Rescue. And redeemed.
Buenas noches, sean todos bienvenidos al Centro Mariano de Aurora.
Good night, be all very welcome to the Marian Center of Aurora. And we are celebrating today the 8th anniversary of the apparition of the Virgin Mary here in America. 8 years ago, in a cold night, in a colder night than this one, Our Lady approached here to Aurora. He entered in our planet with all her consciousness to begin a planetary task, something that we will know later on. And today, we are in here with her project of love because it's a project from her, with her project on the way and with many things yet to do. But we are very happy of being able to accomplish things together with Our Lady. These days, many things happened. We are together in here since the 4th of August, receiving Our Lord. And yesterday we received Our Lady and also the Archangel Michael. And today it's a great day. You will all listen through the messages that Our Lady transmitted this morning, that today is a great day for this race. So we are going to begin with this celebration where there will be many updates, many news, and we are all going to prepare our hearts to the words transmitted by Mary, that surely will bring to us many impulses for this path that we will begin to walk. Today, this morning, midday, the three of us, we all gather as a request by her. And she transmitted the messages that will prepare the hearts to all of us for this night. We need to remember that these messages are a part of the apparition. So now we will begin to participate from them. Fray, would you like to begin? Extra daily message received the 8th of August 2015 in the Marin Center of Aurora, Paysandú, Uruguay, transmitted by Mary, Rose of Peace, to the visionary Friar Elías del Sagrado Corazón on occasion of the 8th anniversary of the apparitions of the Virgin Mary. Their children, on this day, my message is of peace and of innerly preparation for all. At the doors of a new time, my heart follows you, guiding you across the path of redemption, a path that all have been called to live before the start of the Armageddon. My heart is donated to you as a flower when it opens itself to the rays of the sun. My sole purpose is to make you gain consciousness of the truth that very few live in this cycle, a truth that is hidden by the impure hands of a few beings on the earth. For this reason, I come outside the Church to recover and to rescue the dignity and the affiliation of all of the souls with the one and only Celestial Father. In the Church of Christ, my voice was pronounced many times and is still doing it through Medjugorje in this time. But for my children, it seems that many years of warnings and of messages aren't sufficient, so that many of you will not waste the precious time that God gives to you in this moment. I come so that on this 8th of August you may learn to love the word of the celestial hierarchy, which like life and vibration guides you and shows you the way. children. The present time indicates a decadent reality in the life of humanity, and it will not be necessary that I talk about this today, because you already see this around you. It's for this reason, as well as for many others, that my son comes in this cycle to ask your consecration to his most sacred and blessed heart, so that your lives in matter will represent at least 10% of the materialization of the plan of God for this humanity. Children, such is the state of the world and the consciousness of the humanity, since the omission of the majority blinds you completely and does not let you see the greatness of a world that burns out in flames the whole time. For this, as your mother of the Apocalypse, I come to admonish you over the importance of having, in the coming times, a spirit of peace, of neutrality, and above all, of love and of hope. When a consciousness resists changing certain habits of life, which broadly influence in the atrocious of the forces opposing the plan of God, the essence forfeits the cycle, and then it must wait the next opportunity. But my grace is infinite, and it is such sublime grace of God that reunites all under the same goal and the same spiritual proposition. I come to save the last roses from the wildfires of this world. I come to awake the consciousness to the higher reality where the sacred purpose of God reigns and dwells. I come to remind you of the sacred path of prayer, and at the same time I come to remove the bands from your eyes again and again, and in this way you will be able to see that my blessed eyes can see about the destiny of this world. I come so that the scripture of John the Evangelist will be fulfilled in the same way as once Jesus fulfilled it by being the Messiah of Israel. Now all has been said, and it's time for acting from the heart but without haste. The need of light and of mercy is much greater for you and for the kingdoms of nature that are subject to great disasters of human errors that are irreparable in the heart of God. When your attitude is fair, the universe shows its balance. When your action is hasty, falsely powerful, and petty, the universe will be fair in all of the levels of the consciousness. Enter in the new cycle with a greater expansion of your hearts and with a little less of your own ideas. God needs you completely, humble and happy, so that eventually you will be columns of a plan that it is in danger of not being accomplished. All it takes to pray, and not to be and to be a collaborator with the celestial hierarchy, cooperating with the development of the mission of all of the celestial brotherhood. I bless this day that has come at last, so that all will be purified, and in love you will consecrate yourself to the Holy Spirit of God. I thank you for responding to my final call, who unites you to the divine principle of the supreme will, your Mother Mary, Rose of Peace.
Mensaje para la aparición anual del 8 de agosto de 2015.
Message for the annual apparition of the 8th of August of 2015, received in the Marian Center of Aurora, Paysandú, Uruguay, transmitted by Mary, Rose of Peace, to the visionary Sister Lucia de Jesús. When an inner sun illuminates the darkness of your hearts, that is me, children of mine, announcing that the end of chaos is near. This is the definitive principle of the end, the cycle on which every step taken by your actions, thoughts, feelings, and definitions will be placed in the balance of the divine judge, the one that will dictate to angels and archangels what will be the destiny of humanity. Before such ignorance and darkness in the heart of most men of this world, the smallest light will shine as a resplendent sun, and a creature who remains sane and in balance of their prayerful soul may guide the millions who will wander aimless with no destination except their own abyss. My dear ones, my heart will no longer come to the world to warn you, because this I already did on the last 8 years here and on the last 30 in Medjugorje. Many times I came to this world, and many were the attempts to awaken you to a life of prayer, holiness, and peace. From now on, the times that will come no longer expect for you to be ready, because it will precipitate over the world the justice of God, and every being will live according to the merits earned in their days of existence. Many will seek the peace of my heart and will not find it, because they did not want in other times to build the path between their own heart and my source of peace. I shall no longer intercede for the world as before, because until now I took many steps for your feet, but the time has come to begin your own walk and start to generate your own merits, not only for yourselves, but for all humanity. Because today I tell you, my beloved, in this time of justice that announces itself, it will be the own consciousness, conscious humanity, who must open the doors to the mercy and piety, so that mercy and piety may descend upon the unbelievers and the dormant in spirit. Many will regret in time and others not. For this reason, you must be conscientious that the justice of God will not cause harm to the heart, but to each one will give what they deserve to live, their learning in this world. The humanity that today inhabits the surface of the planet is very old and had many opportunities to learn and follow the designs of God, but many preferred to turn the back on celestial things and open the arms to illusion and to the infernal life that manifests itself through the capital energies. The ray of the justice of God will break the ignorance of man, and those who laugh so with the King of Hell will cry for their great ignorance. Those who teased the light will blind their eyes before it, because after everything that will happen, the King will come and give new opportunities to those who repent of heart and extend their hands to Him, crying for pity. My beloveds, prepare your hearts and listen to me carefully, because at this time, I cannot hold the power of my words through the fear that your heart may feel or for the unbelief that may generate in some souls, for the incapacity of transforming themselves to accept my words. It is the will of God that truth be revealed to you, because it will be the part of the awakening of faith and consciousness to see my words being fulfilled in the times to come, times on which I will no longer be here so close to you. When my prophecies become fact, you will look at the skies where I will be observing you, and some will thank, others will ask for forgiveness, but none may say, I did not warn them and did not give them to know the final days of this world. But know that as I announce the times of difficulty and trials, I also tell you that those who walk in faith will not hesitate. Those who make from prayer the pillar of their consciousness will always be a door of peace and a guiding star to humanity. Through these ones, I will guide the world, but you must be brave and persistent, confident on my power, on the power of my word, verb, that announce the times of chaos. But also I told you, at the end of all, your king will come, will cross the clouds and the seven heavens, will step on earth and rebuild it, inside and outside of men, so that in it the new humanity may inhabit. May peace be the engine that leads you and keep you standing on the times to come. Pray, pray and trust in me every instant of your life, because then they will be sanctified by my presence. I love you, bless you, so that in this cycle I shall find you in my heart. Your Mother Mary, Rose of Peace.
Mensaje extraordinario recibido el 8 de agosto de 2015.
Extra message transmitted the 8th of August 2015 in the Marian Center of Aurora, Paysandú, Uruguay, transmitted by the Most Holy Mother of God, Rose of Peace, to the Mother Maria Shimani of the Montserrat. Peace to the heart of the world. Peace to the pilgrims of the world. Peace to all the true servers of God on the whole world. Peace to the new apostles of my Son. Peace, always peace. My beloved children, today a new planetary cycle begins. Today, the planet and its humanity definitely enter an intense cycle of its transition to convert on the times to come in a new civilization. Today starts to my most conscious children the full purification of their beings, so that when the great movements of the Armageddon may begin, they will already be empty of themselves, purified, and may help their brothers and sisters to walk the difficult times that this world will live. For a new humanity to maybe raise, the previous one must be transcended itself in all their aspects without leaving archaic structures crystallized that do not allow that my children may take steps in their consciousnesses. Every being on this earth will be purified, and it will receive the grace of converting in that which God Almighty thought for them. Each being in this world will have an opportunity of expressing the spiritual attributes that the Creator placed in their essence, so that in their experience of life they may serve to the one and only God and all their neighbors. After so many mistakes, so many faults, once again the Eternal Father will send to his firstborn son to this planet, this time dressed in glory, to rescue once more, once again, this race that succumbs day by day on the ignorance, the lack of peace, and the lack of spiritual life. Today, dear children, all the trumpets will be played, and my mantle of light will be expanded for the four corners of the earth to cover all those that in humility define themselves and put themselves under the protection of the Mother of God, the universal feminine consciousness that is in here among you, in order to make this offer once more. Nothing will stop the coming of the new, because thus is written by God on the books of the creation. This is His will, that His holy project may be fulfilled. Remember that the great spiritual victories that resonate in the universe and that change forever the destiny of all the created things are just that, spiritual victories and not material ones. The great divine victory that changed the direction of this creation was the crucifixion of my son, the Nazarene, that to the eyes of the majority back then was a failure and a lie. Do not let yourselves to be fooled for the material events that you will see, because this humanity is so lost that may destroy once again everything that was built by God just for not accepting the truth. For this reason, beloved children, unite yourself to my heart and let that I may do prodigies in your consciousnesses, the ones that will be graved forever in your spirits and that no one will be able to remove from you, to take away from you, because will be experienced and lived by yourselves. This will be your truth, your strengths and your treasures in the time about to come, where your real faith should raise up in a strong way, and it will be the column that will hold you. Remember the days that you had shared in this sacred aurora. Remember the simplicity of this house, the effort that in here is done in order to learn from the sacred things and from the reverence to God. Remember, children, that this is the truth that I am in here with you, the truth that my son had bathed you with his glory and called you companions, that the Holy Michael, the Father, descended from the ultra-terrestrial universes and freed yourselves from the darkness learnings. Guard this truth in your hearts, in your spirits, and do not let that my adversary destroy it. Today I bring the light from the light. Today I bring the light from all of the stars from the firmament, so that I may bless you, so that this codes of universal light may enter in your consciousnesses and may guide you in this final cycle. Here I am your mother of love, the one that may stay in my under my mantle. Nothing will have to fear, because it will be in me and I will be in it. Hail Aurora of my heart, hail humanity in redemption. Thank you for being here today in this sacred ground next to me, your universal mother, Rose of Peace. And with these intense words transmitted by Our Lady, we are going to prepare ourselves in order to present you a novelty, a request made by Our Lady that was awaited for a long time. We are going to sing to rejoice our souls, to
saber de qué se trata.
Y luego saberemos de qué se trata.
Buen trabajo para todos.
Bon trabajo para todos.
To sing to Our Lady, and then we will see what this is about. Beats in a strong way, it shakes from love, preparing this space with fervor. She's arriving.
Right.
Open up your door. Divine Mother, Mary, the intraterrestrial deity manifests itself with love, August, divine brotherhood. She's arriving. Aurora, open your door now.
Ella llegando está, Madre Divina.
She announced us that His Son is arriving, that her Son is arriving, the new love, the peace, the Marian Spirit enters fully in you. It fills you with hope, transforms your living. Aurora, open up your door now. She's arriving.
Aurora, abre tu puerta ya. Ella llegando está.
Instrumentos.
She's arriving, look at her. Divine Mother, Mary,
Madre Divina, Maria, Maria.
Buenas noches a todos.
Good night, everyone.
Hoy estamos aquí en el Centro Mariano de Aurora.
And today we are in here in the Marian Center of Aurora,
atendiendo a un pedido de nuestra Madre Divina.
Answering to a request made by our Divine Mother a couple of weeks ago,
a través de una transmisión feita al Frei Elías del Sagrado Corazón,
through a transmission that was made to Friar Elias del Sagrado Corazón. She, our mother, asked us that today, the 8th of August, through Mercy Mary TV, we may do the official
del libro Mensajes de Paz.
Lodging of the book Messages of Peace,
una obra que está siendo publicada por la editora Irdin,
a book that is being published by Irdin Editora and with the support of Association Mary.
Este libro integra que fueron transmitidos por la Madre Divina,
messages that were transmitted by the Divine Mother
en el periodo de
from November the 15th, 2011 till November the 15th, 2012.
Bien, well, nos fue
when this request
pedido,
was made to us,
and
we began to think about the importance of this. First of all, we felt very honored for the opportunity, for this opportunity, mainly because he chose this date for the release of the book, something that gave us the indication and the confirmation, the reconfirmation of the importance of this task, of this work, from the spiritual point of view.
Well,
beyond this, she requested us something special. She said that it would be very important that everyone may know the spontaneous effort that was done for the manifestation of this book. All of the people, all of the collaborators involved and that were participants of the manifestation of this work. So we thought in doing a list, in creating a list with all of the ones that collaborated in order to manifest this book. And it was something incredible because we began to elaborate this list and it was endless because there were a lot of persons. It was an endless list and there were a lot. So then what began to think, what may happen if we just forget someone? Because they were not only the monks by the Grace Mercy Order, not only the ones living in the communities, the residents and collaborators, but also collaborators, volunteer collaborators from many countries, from Latin America, from the States, and also from countries from Europe.
Editores, redatores, diagramadores e fotógrafos, né? Grupo assim muito grande de pessoas.
So there were not only revisors, translators, people that do the
fotógrafos,
the designs.
Todo lo que imaginem.
Enfim, eu gostaria só de
photographers. For many. So I would also like to add that when we began, when we, the last year, began to see the whole book in order to finish it, that it was in December of last year, we felt and we were able to see that the team of the diffusion, it began to grow up a lot, to grow, to expand a lot. And today we comprehend that this was truly a blessing that Mary accomplished, not only for the materialization of this book, but also to other things to publish.
Tanto essa gratidão propiciar, né, que fique claro a nossa gratidão de poder fazer parte dessa obra.
And knowing that with words it's very difficult to express our gratitude before such in order to express the materialization of this. And also with the expansion of the group, another group appeared, emerged, that made an audio, a video. The group made an offer to Mary in order to express her gratitude and to all of the ones that collaborated in order to materialize this work, the book, Messages of Peace. So, you're going to watch the video, but before that, I would like to make a convocatory. Because all of the collaborators are invited to participate from the materialization of many other books, because this is the first from a collection Divine Messengers that needs to include all of the instructions that we had received, transmitted by the Virgin Mary, Christ Jesus, and Saint Joseph. So there is a lot of work to all of us.
All right. Vamos ver o vídeo. O vídeo já é o encerramento dessa apresentação e da formalização desse lançamento.
So we are going to watch the video, and it's going to be the end of this presentation of the release of the book. Thank you all.
Del cielo y de todo el universo mayor, vengo para
from heaven and from the whole universal. From the all whole universe, I come to awake your consciousness to the infinite life of the cosmos. Feel my sacred words in the heart so that they may sprout up as new fruits in your essences. Always count on with my presence, my help, and my words graved in your heart, in your essences, and in the books of your lives. The responsible ones for the book are the evolutive plan, God, and the very Saint Mary. Mary, the one chose the visionaries, the ones that signed this task, signed the authorship of the book. Friar Elias del Sagrado Corazón was accompanied by divine instructors since he was a child, and Mary chose this period, the date from the 15th of November 2011 till 15th of November 2012, in order to accomplish her first publishment. And this represents many years of apparitions and apparitions and apparitions. We are now going to be publishing the messages that we received from
November 2011 till November 2012. We are in 2015. Mary continues speaking. Now Christ is also speaking, also Saint Joseph. So we have many things ahead in order to publish. But one of the most important things that the hierarchy always taught us is that the message of the higher, by the hierarchy, is atemporal and universal, which means that at any moment that we may get in touch, get in contact with the message, this information will be 100% current, because they work, they deal with other realities, other spaces, so their instructions are current until the days of today, until the present times. We are able to read the gospel, and the things that were placed in the gospel as the messages transmitted by, as the parables transmitted by Jesus, are current things, even 2,000 years later. So a characteristic by the messages transmitted by the hierarchy of the light is that their instruction is atemporal. It works to any person in any part of the world at any time. And we are able to see this in this new book, Messages of Peace. When we were in Medjugorje, in a moment of prayer, she appeared to us and she told us that she was going to begin to transmit us 1 year of the daily messages, because she considered that they were very important, because they were going to prepare us for this current times, for the critical times about to come. And it was just what happened. And for us, it was a very unusual situation, because she asked us to pray, to prepare the space and the moment during the prayer. She always placed us a moment, always, she always scheduled us a moment and a time where she was going to approach to us in order to accomplish this task. And as a mother, she guides us step by step so that we may in this way enter into the universe of her heart, and that we may comprehend the purpose that she was placing to us at that moment. That for us was something unknown, because we didn't know what it was going to happen until the time came when Mary asked us that we may publish her messages. It's time to walk, to overcome barriers and obstacles. When we were in Medjugorje in the month of November, one day, Friar Elias, he reunited himself with us, and he told us that Mary arrived during the prayer that he was doing, and that she transmitted him a message, and she requested us that we may prepare ourselves to receive 1 year of daily instructions, and that he wishes that the whole world may receive these instructions. And she asked us that in just a short period of time, I think that they were like 48 hours, for us to create a website in order to publish over there her messages. It was a great experience for us in order to prepare this, in order to bring her message, to take her message of peace to the whole world. And this is how everything began. When the first year of messages ended, a collaborator from our work, a friend, she approached to us and she brought us printed a book, and next to that book she gave us a CD with a cover saying that it was the book of the daily messages of Mary. And for us it was a great joy, and we felt that that was an impulse, that if Mary blessed it, it should be fulfilled. But from the Association Mary, the books for the hierarchy are the lowest elements in order to transmit their messages, their instructions. on these times, Mary is wishes to use all of the media in order to place her messages, in order to place what she needs, and we are guardians of that information. When we had the importance, when we knew how the elaboration of the book was going on, she also began to guide us and to correct us as a good mother that she is, so that everything might be in the spirit of the simplicity, which is the spirit that Our Lady has and that shows to us day by day in her daily messages. I come in between the clouds in order to announce a time of great changes. When it began, it was something like with a lot of devotion, of a lot of surrender to Mary, and we thought that it was going to be something of 2 months of work. And if we now see all of the things that happened, they were more than 2 years of editing, and everything developed in something much more professional. The quality changed, the revisers were getting better, they found new details, even the pictures changed. Throughout these years of apparitions, more than 10 photographers participated, and a great challenge was to choose only 15 pictures in order to appear on the book. There are many people that were involved since the messages received to the visionary Fray Elias until that nowadays is printed on a paper. There were many people involved in this, that through their volunteer work they were able to accomplish through their effort to this become materialized. It was something very exigent, but at the same time, it was a work that was done with a lot of dedication and joy, and we all had the objective, the goal, that everything do not be good, but to become something perfect, because we try to gave our best so that Mary may have a work that we know that is going to stay for humanity, and we need to express a very precise dedication, but also it was an inner change very big. We began to do the revision of the book, it transformed, and it was like our daily liturgy. We were awaiting for the moment in order to publish the book. There were many things that Mary worked on us also, for example, our patience, our persistence of saying, okay, we just go, because the idea was to do it the best as possible, because is the word by Mary, because it needs to be just perfect. The patient is a flame that never goes out. Unite yourself to my heart. Be brave. Get courage to follow me. Mary became, on these days, into a very precise instructor. She conducted us almost minute by minute in our life. She explained to us that if we may pray, if we pray, we are going to create in the subtle planes other things that will begin to balance the movements of the planet. Predilected children, it's time of the great transformation. It's time to transcend in order to love, to be able to love. So the work with the prayer, as the very same Virgin Mary indicates to us, is the tool, is an instrument so that we may protect that everything might be in the best way as possible, in the most harmonious way as possible, with all of the difficulties that present. But through prayer, we feel, we perceive that everything might be made, find a solution, and we feel the how our Divine Mother accompanies us. We pray at the graphic with the sisters and brothers while we were preparing the book. So it was a very fraternal, ecumenic process. Mary worked on each single part of the book with brothers and sisters that are in the group and others that not aren't exactly related, but she was there with all of us. And this is a very rich experience to all of us, because the whole group of translators, the ones that do the revisions, the editors, they had to work for a lot of months in order to get to this moment and to have the book Messages of Peace done, the one that today is going to be presented to all. Entering in the graphic, it was like entering into an airport, because the sound of the machines, it was like incredible. The book is a mystery. It reflects a mystery of who is Mary. And you entering in contact, getting in touch in a continuous way, you begin to penetrate into a mystery, and we begin to perceive from where that came from, because that came from a very higher level and began to descend plan after plan, vibration after vibration, and each plasm in a writing material, which means that this comes from a sublime place, and then it transforms in a literally writing. And this, for us, is a mystery, and this is in the energy of the book. Our intentions for the lecture. I have now at this moment a suggestion in order to make to all of the readers that may have the opportunity of getting close to this work. My suggestion is this one. I suggest that the book might be written as an ordinary book. I may be read as an ordinary book at the beginning, not to stop on each message. On the other hand, to read all the messages in a row all together, because I I got in contact with the book in this way, and when I was on the page around 60, I went through an inner process. I didn't read message by message. I just read it as it is an ordinary book, as you read it from the beginning to the end. And this begins to create a contact in between you and the book. This creates a bond, a relation in between you and the book. But this and this relation might be more perfect and deeper if you may get in contact with the whole work to comprehend. And then, when you finish, then you will go back to those paragraphs that are related with your special evolutive thing, with the things that you have more necessary to get in touch. The book has all of this in its aura. The book has all of this and its content. It is not just the written thing, it's you to accompany the process that you begin to do, the inner process that you begin to do while you enter in contact, while you get in contact with the book, and then when you begin to deep on each step, on each point, each day of lecture, because it's a daily lecture, which means that daily in its original way. So you are going to go through an experience, and I, myself, I do the vows for you to make this experience in the deepest way as possible, and that you may receive a great lesson of love at the end. Because at the end, we realized that we receive a great lesson of love and a great lesson of patience. Patience from the divinity towards us. We thank to all of the ones that lovingly dedicate themselves to the elaboration of the book Messages of Peace, our gratitudes to the monks from the Grace Mercy Order, to the residents from the Community of Lights, and mainly to all of the volunteer collaborators from different countries that helped for the edition of this book. Gathered for a higher plan, next to our mother, next to the Lord, firmly walking towards a new humanity, with a consciousness of love and fraternity. Let's sing as if we were one voice with peace and hope for a better world. Unite yourself to the heart of Mary. Where stars will shine. Unite yourself to the heart of Mary. Always together in prayer. Pleading to heaven for our salvation.
Buscamos la
With our brothers and sisters, we look for unity between nations, peace and humility, under the very same sun, under the same God. We all waiting for Christ our King.
Al amor de María.
Y vamos a comenzar en este 8 de agosto.
And we are going to begin on this 8th of August
a Nuestra Señora.
To pray to Our Lady,
a unirnos a sus atributos universales,
to unite yourselves to her universal attributes,
que ella nos enseñó desde el principio,
with that prayer that she taught us from the beginning,
que quería que nosotros hiciéramos orar a todo el mundo esa oración,
and that she wanted us to make pray this prayer to the whole world. And today we know,
a partir de que muchos peregrinos nos escriben desde el mundo entero,
that since the fact that many pilgrims write to us from the whole world, that in the most faraway places in this world, even from brothers and sisters that we don't even know, this prayer vibrates in their hearts. So we are going to pray all together, the Universal Mother. We praise you, O Supreme Mother. Plain is your full is your grace. Unity is in you. Sacred feminine energy. You gestate within yourself the new humanity. O Supreme Universal Mother. Intercede for us, beings from the surface of the earth, that we may consecrate ourselves as worthy children of God, in faith, in light, in peace, in protection, in healing, in unity, in love, in forgiveness, in reconciliation, in charity, in humility, in transmutation, and in fraternity, now and at the moment of our total and final surrender to the Creator Father. Amen.
Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti. Sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén. Te alabamos, oh Madre Universal, plena es tu gracia, la unidad está en ti, sagrada energía femenina, gestas en ti la nueva humanidad. Oh Suprema Madre Universal, intercede por nosotros, seres de la superficie de la tierra, para que podamos consagrarnos como dignos hijos de Dios, en la fe, la luz, la paz, la protección, la cura, la unidad, el amor, el perdón, la reconciliación, la caridad, la humildad, la transmutación y en la fraternidad, ahora y en el momento de nuestra total y definitiva entrega al Padre Creador. Amén.
Una más.
Te alabamos, We praise you,
O universal Mother, full is your grace, unity is in you, sacred feminine energy, you shall state within yourself the new humanity. O Supreme Universal Mother, intercede for us, beings from the surface of the earth, that we may consecrate ourselves as worthy children of God, in faith, in light, in peace, in protection, in unity, in love, in forgiveness, in reconciliation, in charity, in humility, in transmutation, and in fraternity, now and at the moment of our total and final surrender to the Creator Father. Amen.
Y ahora vamos a cantar una canción que los videntes le hicieron a Nuestra Señora.
And we are going to sing now a song that the visionaries made to Our Lady and as a request by her for this day. It's a song that counts a story from an 8th of August when this world was blessed by the consciousness of Our Lady, where she entered in this corner of the world with all of her heavenly consciousness in order to bring to us her peace, the reconciliation to God, the new filiation to his Son, her Son, this safe place to the heart of the Redeemer. Lady, with all our humility, our love is in this song. More brilliant, more radiant than the sun. Holy Mary, Hail Mary appeared, bringing her message of plea and salvation. It was a cold night when the Mother came. She showed her radiant beauty, more radiant than the sun. Holy Mary, Divine Mother,
Santa Maria, Madre Divina, más radiante que el sol. Tú nos diste un mensaje.
You gave us a message. Pray with the heart. Pray for the world with a lot of devotion. Thus my Son will come in glory and in redemption, opening new doors of healing and liberation. Holy Mary, Virgin Mary, you are pure. You are healing and liberation. Oh Mary, your rays illuminate us, proving graces and love.
Oh, Maria.
concepción. Tus rayos nos iluminan, derramando gracias y amor.
Eight years of mercy and forgiveness, that all may get happy because Mary has come. You are the one crowned by the stars. You are the fire of our prayer. You are the infinite grace.
Eres la madre de Dios.
You are the mother of God.
Oh, dulce reina y madre.
Oh, sweet king, queen and mother. Higher governor. In your arms, you take us to Christ. To our salvation.
Santa María apareció, mostró su belleza radiante, más radiante que el sol.
Santa María,
Santa María, Madre Divina, más radiante.
Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original.
Immaculate Lady of Peace, manifestation of the original purity, permit us to enter into your heart, sacred kingdom of love and of protection. May your mantle of light guard us and transform our little beings into servants of your universal task. We revere you, Mother, Queen of Peace, Divine Conception of the Trinity. Amen. Immaculate Lady of Peace, manifestation of the original purity, permit us to enter into your heart, sacred kingdom of love and of protection. May your mantle of light guard us and transform our little beings into servers of your universal task. We revere you, Mother, Queen of Peace, Divine Conception of the Trinity. Amen.
Amen. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original,
permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén. Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza original, permítenos ingresar en tu corazón, reino sagrado del amor y la protección, que tu manto de luz nos guarde y transforme nuestros pequeños seres en siervos de tu tarea universal. Te reverenciamos, Madre, Reina de la Paz, Divina Concepción de la Trinidad. Amén.
Una más.
Inmaculada Señora de la Paz, manifestación de la pureza
Immaculate
original,
Lady of Peace, manifestation of the original purity, permit us to enter into your heart, sacred kingdom of love and of protection. May your mantle of light guard us and transform our little beings into servants of your universal task. We reveal you, Mother, Queen of Peace, divine conception of the Trinity. Amen.
Amén.
Cántico 19.
Madre.
Aurora, you told us the truth that this earth moves, that nothing will stop him, that we may pray, that we may sing, because everything will change. Mother, you told us that from the heart we will feel you, that the eyes, that with faith, open, will see me, that in August, in Aurora, my presence will be, will be there. Mother, your message of warning you will give us, that the prayer of your children may open the door from where you will arrive, that you bring to us the good news that your son is arriving. Mother, give us the strength and courage to overcome these changes, these tests that the planet will face. Mother, that your love may protect us and may bring us peace.
Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo.
Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve, María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros, pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve, María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros, pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve, María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros, pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén.
Inhalamos, vamos a cantar Santa María de Aurora.
Ave María, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Hail Mary,
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre.
Benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus.
Un ángel de Nuestra Señora está pidiendo que las personas que están en las carpas
is asking that everyone that is on the trains very slowly approach to the house of prayer.
Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset Adonai imer.
Hail Mary in Hebrew.
Ubarut pribit nech Yeshua Miriam hakdosha.
Por favor, abran las ventanas de la casa.
Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset Adonai imer, bruchat ad banashim, ubarot privit net Yeshua, Miriam hakdosha, em Elohenu, hit balali beadenu, achoteim ata, uvishad motenu. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset Adonai imech, bruchat ad banashim, ubarut privit net Yeshua, Miriam hakdoshad, em Elohenu, hit balali beadenu, achoteim ata, ubishad motenu. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset
Adonai imech. Bruchat ad banashim, ubaruch privit nech Yeshua, Miriam hakdosha, em Elohenu, hitbalelim beadenu, achoteim ata, uvishad motenu. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset Adonai imech, bruchat ad banashim, ubaruch privit nech Yeshua, Miriam hakdosha, em Eloheinu, hit baveli deadenu, achoteim ata, uvishad moteinu. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat ad eset, Adonai imech, bruchat ad banashim, ubarut privit nech, Yeshua, Miriam hakdosha, em Eloheinu,
Hidva veli beatenu, hafoteim atah, uvishad noteinun. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset, Adonai imeh, bruchat ad banashim, uvarut pribinet Yeshua, Miriam ad kosha, em Eloheinu, Hidva veli beatenu, hafoteim atah, uvishad noteinun. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset, Adonai imeh, bruchat ad banashim, uvarut pribitnet, Yeshua, Miriam hadosha, en Eloheinu, hitva benibeadenu, ahotein atah, uvishat moteinu. Amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset, Adonai imeh, Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset, Adonai imeh, bruchat ad banashim, ubaruch pribitnech, Yeshua, Miriam hadoshat, em Eloheinu, hipaleli be'adeinu, ahotein atah, uvishat moteinu, amen. Shalom lach Miriam, bruchat acheset, Adonai imeh, Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre.
pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores,
ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén.
Nestes tempos, o mundo não busca a luz.
Nestes tempos,
at these times, the world do not look for the light. But I come from heaven in order to let you know this, the light, the powerful and sublime light that pours out from the heart of God to the world and to all of the universes. Today, I'm in here with you, dear children, commemorating with my most sacred heart this special encounter with my consciousness that unites all of your consciousnesses with the Son of God, Jesus Christ. I come to restore in this day your lives in order to restore your paths, material and spiritual paths, so that you may follow my call straight to the heart of the Creator. This is my greatest prodigy for your lives, that you may follow an unique path through my Immaculate Heart. This is why I come to call you, not only to prayer, but also to the accomplishment of your spiritual task on this mission of the 144,000 of the new apostles of my Son. Do you believe that you are one of them? I come to reveal this prophecy to you, because the sign is very visible on these times, that the world needs to deeply change before everything happens. My voice is not only announced in Medjugorje, also I come to this part of America, and not only to consecrate it to the plan of God, but also to consecrate it through the peoples, so that among them the new apostles of Christ may emerge, the ones that will share the gifts and the graces to all of the ones that may need them. This is why my heart is perseverant, children, beloved children. And today, a cycle finished before your lives, and a spiritual and superior cycle to the world. And a new cycle is coming. It's beginning at this right moment, in this real time of God, where everyone is invited to place before, over and over, through the elevation of the prayer of the heart, through your communion with Christ, and through your repentance before the divine laws. For this, I come dressed of the sun to illuminate your paths, to open up your eyes, to open your hearts, and so that you may feel the purpose of God in your hearts, the purpose of God through me. Today, my whole consciousness is manifested in this place. This is how God allowed it for this end of the times, where everyone is called to live a deep reflection in the consciousness, to change the habits from your lives, to correct your paths, and to follow the path of the shepherd, which is the real path, which is the real hierarchy for this galaxy, this solar system, and this little world among the whole universe. Do you know what this means, dear children? I come to reveal to you the mysteries of God, those deep secrets that the divine that in the divine life of the sacred hearts of the sacred family were fully lived in the absolute confidence that all of this was real to the evolution of the hearts from the world. I come with the aspiration of a good mother in order to institutionalize the principle of a new humanity, strengthened through the faith, the love, the unity, and mainly through the confidence that your lives purified in Christ will find the goal that you look for so long, that you look for a long time. The goal, your goal, dear children, is found beyond other philosophies. I invite you to live the philosophy of my maternal heart, which is the perfect vibration of the love of God, manifested in the heart of your heavenly mother. Today, I present once again to you my immaculate heart as this perfect offer to may live redemption and peace in and outside yourselves, so that the confused paths may vanish and the light of God may emerge once again in all of the steps that you may take towards the Lord. My heart is a manifested star among you. It comes from the universe, crossing these portals of light in order to pour the graces that God conceded on this day. I would deeply wish every day of my omnipresent life that you all may see me. But trust in the will of God. It's already a grace for your hearts that you may call for this holy day to renew your spiritual vows with the Creator and to free your knots from the ties, from clearer paths, from the life that this sick humanity promises. Today, I come to heal many of your hearts that are sick and that need from their relief, from the attributes of the Universal Mother. If you may live these attributes, I assure you, dear children, that you won't lose this path to the infinite that today you're all invited to live in this principle of peace that I spread to your lives and to the world as a mother of this humanity, princess and mother of this world, commander from all these hearts. Today, on this 8th of August, I come to unite your hearts with the sublime Spirit of God. What you know as the one and only source. My heart is this portal, which is open today before your eyes to your souls with a deep maternal love with a glance of a good mother, so that you all may get the courage in order to walk towards me and to consecrate your lives regarding your possibilities. I come to offer you this last offer on this date. This is the greater grace that God has conceded me, that God granted me after these 8 years. 8 years of walked next to you patiently in the love and in the truth, so that your hearts may grow in faith and be nourished by the Holy Spirit of my children, of my son. God has granted me, beloved children, that my son may arrive here in order to open the doors of this aurora, so that the hearts may be free, may be liberated, redeemed, and healed through the Archangel Michael. But this is a task, it's a spiritual mission of our sublime hearts before this unloyal world that looks for results in other things, in other paths, that loses the souls and that removes them from God each day more and more. This is why the universe is surrounding my aura, my light blue aura, in order to radiate to you the strength that you need, so that you may get the courage to follow my steps, so simple and humble that actually, dear children, if you get courage to leave them, you will materialize your tasks, which are the works of God to the world. But today I'm not only in here, but also I'm surrounded by the angels from heaven, from all of the celestial hierarchies that answer to the greater will of the Creator. Today I'm uniting this spiritual universe from where I'm from with your spiritual life, a material life of sorrow and pain that must be rescued for my spirit of peace before everything happens. While I'm talking to you, dear children, I work in your hearts so that they may achieve the light of the redemption of Christ, so needed and urgent, to rehabilitate all of the hearts that walk next to the darkness of my adversary. But I walk with my feet on this ground of Aurora, the head of the snake, so that she may stop making the souls to be loose, and me, from now on, I might be your governess, your universal mother, your guiding star, that may guide your steps, your paths and your families towards the new repairing communion with Christ at the definite moment of his second return to the earth. Blessed be the ones that believe not seeing me, because in truth they know the kingdom of God. Blessed be the ones that listen with the ears from the heart, because they will feel the Holy Spirit of the Creator. Blessed be the ones that repent themselves from the heart, that abandon their ties, so that the aurora of my heart may banish, may destitute all the evils from this world, and the doors of the redemption may be open over the hearts that get lost, for not wanting to follow the Mother of Heaven. I bring to you real words, definitive for your lives. I bring to you the superior healing, feminine principle, sacred and immaculate principle for this universal life. I come to open up your eyes so that you may reach your soul, and so that your soul may live in the Spirit of God for the centuries that will come.
É por isso que abro neste mundo.
Es por eso que abro en este mundo.
Todas as portas que os separam do universo.
To the world.
Todas las puertas que nos separan del universo.
All the doors that separate us from the universe.
Tempo de Deus,
and unite us to the.
I
unite the world of God to the time of this world. To heal all the errors from the past.
Um passado que desconhece.
A past that you do not know.
Que não provém deste mundo.
Que não proviene deste mundo.
It's not from this world. But it's in my heart. But my heart can see it and cure it from your consciousness. I come to liberate all the ties with evil of those that say yes to my immaculate heart. But that yes must be true
and
that they manifest in the days of your lives. I await my children that you have not come to my encounter for curiosity of knowing what happens in this sacred earth, the sacred land, to be here because you want your transformation definitely, to liberate the ties of the past and be reborn to a new knowledge, to a new life, to a new humanity that must be seeded all your hearts and your consciousness. Do not wait, my loved ones, that this humanity surge must be constructed through the purification and transformation, conscious purification of each one of you,
but
love for God and for His perfect plan must be greater than the love for the things of this world. Because my adversary will seek all ways to feed your aspirations and desires that tie you and keep you to the illusions of this world, and will look for the ways that these aspirations seem real and spiritual. For this, open your hearts, your eyes, not the eyes of the mind, but yes, the eyes of the heart, because it's through the heart, my loved ones, that you will hear my voice. And you will know that she is the carrier of God's will for your lives, as for all humanity, as for the whole universe, that in this day consecrates around my mantle to observe the hearts of the world and contemplate God's plan. The universe awaits the response of all humanity. For this, I ask you today, brave in spirit as in body, to abandon the past and surrender to the new future, this that I bring before your eyes as an opportunity for redemption. This redemption is available to all. But if you don't say yes, and you do not propose to transform your lives, this healing will pour over this soil and will return to its source without touching your consciousness. Remember, my loved ones, recognize the great loss that will be for this whole race if you do not accept to say yes to the power of God that manifests through His servant. Let me dissolve the fear from your hearts. Let me heal the lack of faith. For this way, I will be able to shape you and protect you so that you can transit in the times that will come. Even though the events of the world do not abandon God's plan is to manifest in His creatures the certitude of perfection, the perfection of His plan, and that these children of God accept to follow the light beyond the darkness that surrounds them. It's for this, my children, that today I bring the light from the divine source, the one that originated the consciousness of the cosmos, as of this planet. This source of light is your essence, this that today I look to light, to relight, so that it may manifest in this cycle a new act of redemption and reconciliation with God, announcing this way to the cosmos that the manifestation of God's plan is possible, and that the beginning of this new cycle, this one that announces the end of decadency, human decadency, of part of the humanity, part of humanity has chosen to follow God's plan. I need, my children, that you do not only listen to my words, but have a straight path, look firmly into my Immaculate Heart, and don't walk through another path, but through this one that leads you to my heart. I aspire that you are not here only, that you are not here with me today, only today, but every day of your life.
Que se vençam a si mesmos. E todas as tendências deste mundo infiel. en todas las tendencias de este mundo infiel.
You must awaken to
para
all.
Seguir meus pasos, para seguir mis pasos.
Os que os conduzem, you must follow my paths.
Os que los conduzem,
those that
Redentor,
lead you to the, to the redemption.
Que proclamem
proclaim
Deus
the Son of God every day.
Every
vidas, instant of your life.
De vuestras vidas.
Que
anunciem a vitória do rei.
Announce the victory.
Que anunciem la victoria del rey del universo.
Of the King of the universe in your consciousness. Through your transformation. Live my words. Do not only listen, but live them. Because this is the great possibility that I bring to you this night. Live my words.
On this holy day, I invite you to leave the path of the love, this path of love that humanity is missing for being distant from God and for choosing other things that do not nourish the spirit, that do not make the life shine as God has predicted it. This is why tonight I'm going to bless the sacred book, which is the greater aspiration of my perfect love for you. I wish that you may take them as a path in order to find the light. Let's sing Immaculate Heart of Mary. Immaculated Heart of Mary. Path of protection and guidance. Thank you for all that you give us.
Queridos filhos,
dear children, I bless this book because are the words that God taught me, the ones that today I transmit to you with all of the maternal love from my heart, that these blessed pages might be written in the humility of the Spirit, in the simplicity of the heart that looks for the perfect union with God, that your souls and the souls of your brothers and sisters, each time that they read these files, these words from my maternal heart might be spiritually light up, reascend, and to definitely establish the union with the Father the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But today, I also bless your hearts, because my grace is poured today over your lives and over the souls from the whole world. This is the only thing that I wish, dear children, that you may live in unity and in love, so that in the world many things do not happen for the simple fact of not wanting to listen. I bless these fruits that represent the tree of life. Each one of you is a fruit for my heart, and through this simple basket I present this offer to the Creator, because He will see with His merciful eyes that you are already ripe to live the universal life.
Aurora,
shelter us. If you've got a simple heart with pure intentions of looking for the union with God, the Divine Mother is asking that we sing the canticle that we had offered her, because it represents for her the voice of all of her children, looking for the simplicity and the humility from His Immaculate Heart. She said, I am in here, in my house, from the humility. I bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Do never close the doors from your hearts, because in this way I will be able to enter.
Hermanos van a entregar una naranja para los que están aquí dentro. Por favor. Y María nos decía que.
And Mary also told us that we may get this orange as a fruit from His simple heart. At the 8th of August, Mary appeared, bringing her message of plea and salvation. It was a cold night when the Mother came. When the Mother arrived, showing her radiant beauty, more radiant than the sun. Hail Mary, Holy Mary, Divine Mother, more radiant than the sun. you gave us a message. Pray with heart. Pray for the world with a lot of devotion. Thus, my son will come in glory and in redemption, opening new doors of healing and liberation. Of healing and liberation. Mary, Divine Conception, your rays illuminate us, pouring graces and love. Your rays illuminate us, pouring graces and love.
Cumplimos 8 años.
We made 8 years of mercy and forgiveness. That all may rejoice. Mary had come. That all may rejoice. Mary had come. You are the one crowned by stars. You are the fire of our prayer. You are the infinite grace. You are the Mother of God. O sweet Queen and Mother, greater governess, in your arms you take us to Christ. To our salvation.
Santa María apareció, mostró su belleza radiante, más radiante que el sol.
Santa María, Madre Divina,
más radiante que el sol.
Santa María, Madre Divina,
más radiante.
María.
Gracias, Madre, por cuanto nos das.
Thank you, Mother, for all that you give us.